They are not finished yet. Jameer Nelson and the Magic have become the third team in NBA history to win Game 4 on the road after losing the first three games of a series. Tonight, they will try and send this series back to Boston for a Game 6. Crazy drama unfolds on Game 5 next on ESPN.
At last, passion, intensity, and a victory.
Has to be with our defense. Move that ball. Trust each other.
In an overtime thriller, the Boston Celtics could not finish off the Orlando Magic. Now, the defending Eastern Conference champions have a pulse. Will the home team recapture their Magic Kingdom? Another elimination game looms large for Orlando. Celtics. Magic. Game 5 of the Eastern Conference Finals is next on ESPN.
Welcome to Kia NBA Shootaround.
What's good? Put away the brooms and buckle up the seat, but all of a sudden, things just got a lot more interesting in the Eastern Conference Finals. Welcome to Kia NBA Shootaround. I'm Stuart Scott alongside Michael Wilbon, John Berry, and five-time champion and Hall of Famer Irvin Magic Johnson. Guys, Game 5 is on. What is your one key to this game tonight?
Well, I want to see if the same chippiness that Orlando played with, the same focus, the same mindset, will they come back at home and play for that same respect that they played with and for in Game 4?
I'm going to say Rajon Rondo.
That simple.
Yeah, just Rondo, that's period.
Just Rondo, Rondo. Be Rondo.
I'm going to go back to Magic's thought, but condense it to one guy on Orlando, Vince Carter, playing at home. I don't mean just on his home floor.
Right.
I mean at home. This is why they brought him back.
At home. He's from Daytona Beach right down the road. You know, on Monday's Kia NBA Shootaround, you guys literally swept Orlando out. I mean, literally. In fact, Wilbon was like brushing off, you know, dandruff.
I was sweeping like this.
You were sweeping like this. Wilbon brushing dandruff. You don't even have dandruff.
Nope. Years since that happened.
And you get it on your goatee?
But Stan Van Gundy's bunch would not go quietly. After being blown out of the Garden in Game 3, Orlando showed some grit, some chutzpah, some flavor, brass, whatever your word, they showed it, keeping hope alive that they'll be the first team in 94 tries to come back from a 3-0 deficit and win an NBA playoff series. So, unlike Jack Bauer, their season still kicking. Here's a look back at Game 4's overtime thriller and who at Orlando's version of CTU was the Magic's Chloe, always watching their back.
They are the Eastern Conference champions, all right? Until somebody beats them. Until somebody beats them.
We're set for the tip-off, and as you can hear from the crowd, they are fired up.
Alley-oop to Howard. Howard wanting it, gets it. Tough turnaround shot, banks it in.
Oh, I thought Dwight was great. Obviously a huge performance from him tonight.
Howard to the basket, flips it up and in. Nice move from Dwight Howard. Well, what a difference, just such a more aggressive Orlando Magic team.
Well, we have big leads. Now we don't. So we just got to play every possession as a single possession.
Pierce to the basket, throws it down. Allen for three. It's good. Two-point game.
And you're down 3-0, you know, what you're fighting against is that human nature to just sort of let it go.
Here's the drive, gets inside, blocking foul, count it, and one.
There were a couple plays down the stretch offensively that we botched.
Pierce looking, nearly stripped, knocked down, picks it up, ball lost. And we'll have the first overtime of the 2010 playoffs.
When you look at it, half our team was standing next to Paul. I mean, the execution was so bad. I thought we executed poorly throughout the game.
Nelson for three. Banks it in. Jameer Nelson. And the Magic go up by three.
I didn't call the bank shot, but it went in. And I'm happy that it did because it was a big shot, a crucial point in the game.
Nelson. Nelson. Again, back-to-back threes for Jameer Nelson. And the Orlando Magic avoid the sweep and keep their season alive.
We've just made it more difficult for ourselves. But, you know, listen, no one said this was going to be easy.
We didn't want to go home.
Well, definitely there's no need to panic.
We didn't win this game just to win a game and say we were in this series, you know. We want to make this a series and win this series.
You know, how ridiculous was Dwight Howard's game four? Since the merger, he becomes only the fourth player ever to put up 30 and 15 in an elimination road game. Dwight has some pretty good company in that group, as you see. He joins Dirk Nowitzki, Hakeem Olajuwon, and Marcus Johnson, who did it way back in the day. So how do the Celtics bounce back from a disappointing loss?
It's a mental approach you got to have. You got to be able to put that behind you and focus on that day. To where you know the things that you have to do to get the win. And that's all there is to it. I think it makes you a little bit more motivated after a loss.
That's who we've been all year. You know, when we play well, we play well because we have great experience. When we lose because we're too old. We're tired. We did play tired or uninspired. And so when we play uninspired basketball, then we're a tired team, an old team.
And what Doc was just talking about is reflected right here. Let's go next level to show you how the Magic found some magic in game four. First three games, Orlando struggled on the pick and roll. Only 28 points per game on less than 36% shooting. But game four, they ran 43 pick and rolls for 47 points and shot over 51%. With more, let's head up to Boston. Doris Burke with an update on Rajon Rondo's muscle spasms in his leg.
Stuart, point guard play is a hot topic of conversation as we approach game five. Rajon Rondo experiencing right leg spasms in game four that had an impact on his play. He assured media today that he is fine and ready to go. When we spoke to Doc Rivers this morning, he has said and remains staunch in his belief that Jameer Nelson is the key, and they have got to do a better job in pick and roll situations. The Magic running double and triple screens, they have got to do a better job guarding those. We'll see how they do tonight, Stu.
Doris, thank you very much. You know, Boston took both games in Orlando, but the Magic have not lost three straight games at home since December of 2007. Magic, what does the team, the Magic, have to do to avoid three straight losses and avoid their own personal golf season, I guess?
Well, I want to see Dwight Howard bring that same energy, that same focus, that same mean and toughness that he brought, because the team fed off of Dwight Howard. And the way Dwight goes, the team goes. And I hadn't seen that look on Dwight Howard's face in the first three games. And hopefully he'll bring that same type of toughness today.
And he had that look in the post-game interview as well.
Exactly.
I think Jameer Nelson has got to be the guy, too. He played terrific in game four. He had 9 assists. He was the playmaker that we've always talked that Orlando was lacking. We talked about Hedo Turkoglu not being there this year. He was their best playmaker last year. Jameer Nelson became that playmaker. They didn't have one in the first three games. They did, but it was J.J. Redick. And he can't be your best playmaker. Jameer Nelson has got to be that guy. When he plays this way, he can get Rashard Lewis into the game. He played better in game four. He can get other guys like Redick and Petrus and Brandon Bass, who's now being used. Those guys all played better, but there was one guy who didn't quite do so hot. Will be?
Vince Carter. I mean, Jameer Nelson and Dwight Howard were the guys that energized their team thoroughly in game four. But tonight, to me, is going to have to be Vince Carter. You think about it, you know, this is a defining playoff series for him, but he's had great playoffs before, and people forget that. Vince Carter once, and this is a series in 2001 against the 76ers. Listen to these numbers. 35 points, 28, 50, 25 and 10, 39 and 20. That's one series. Okay, another series, he scored 30 points three times in a series when he was playing for New Jersey against Indiana. Vince Carter is no stranger to big playoff games, and now he's at home. I mean, literally at home in front of his home fans. I would think a little anxious about shooting 1 for 9 in game four. I think Vince Carter is the guy. I'm expecting him to have a huge game.
Conference finals for any of those, though? Any of those numbers?
It's more like the
they
second
weren't.
Round.
Exactly. Hey, yeah, so
round
he has
a big difference.
It is a big difference.
And
this is another step forward.
Coming off a 1 for 9 shooting performance, and now you're playing in front of your home fans and your family. How does that affect you, Magic?
Well, it definitely affects you because you're supposed to be the player that was going to get them the world championship. And that's why they brought Vince Carter in. But I want to give kudos to J.J. Redick, coming off the bench, averaging 11 points, But he brings a toughness, and his defensive presence also, he's done a wonderful job of guarding Ray Allen. And give Coach Van Gundy a lot of credit. In the fourth quarter, guess who's out on the court? J.J. Redick.
Good point. The Magic took one step on Monday, and it's not unprecedented if they take the second step tonight, because if Orlando wins this game, they will become the sixth team since the merger to win games 4 and 5 after dropping the first three games of a series. But none of those teams, of course, went on to win the series, and only two of those teams even pushed it to a game 7. As for Boston, the Seas have been up 3-0 in a series 11 times in their history. They've never been pushed to a game 6. If they are pushed to a game 6, expect to see some Bruins Flyers highlights in our show Friday, because you know, Flyers came back on Boston. Plenty more still ahead as Kia NBA Shootaround rolls on.
Still ahead. The Suns have evened their series with the Lakers. Who has the edge in a crucial Game 5 in L.A.?
Dwight, I need you on the floor. You cannot commit fouls. Stay on the floor. Points and rebounds are tough to come by when you're sitting next to me. Hey, come with me. We'll go into the virtual world with the Orlando Magic.
Then, the Magic have no more margin for error. Will they grab a second straight win and send this series back to Boston? Game 5 of the Eastern Conference Finals is next on ESPN.
Some guys have never even had a mic, so beer is all they ever drink?
Yeah. It's like being with the same woman your whole life.
Getting married this weekend.
That one's on him.
Don't forget the mics. Lemonade for grown-ups.
Bill Johnson is still one of the few remaining people who haven't tried our new Domino's pizza. That ends today. Bill Johnson, how you doing?
Now get two medium, two-topping pizzas for just $5.99 each. Know a holdout? Tell us at pizzaholdouts.com and you could win free pizza for a year.
The number 10. It's more than just a number. It's reserved for the best. The playmaker. The leader. The one who will be remembered forever. Wear it well. And an entire nation will wear it with you. The 2010 FIFA World Cup on ESPN.
Kia NBA Shootaround, brought to you by the all-new 2011 Kia Sorento, official vehicle of the NBA.
Rajon Rondo and the Celtics have won 4 straight on the road. That ties a playoff club record for a single postseason. They've only done it twice before, but they haven't done it since 1974. How hard is it to win on the road in the playoffs? Why don't we just ask the Lakers and Suns, who haven't been able to do it in their series. Game 4 last night in the Valley of the Sun. And the Suns came out focused on evening the series at 2 apiece. First quarter play to a draw. There's the focus. It was tied at 23, but Magic, what stood out about the first quarter?
Well, Kobe Bryant had 0 points. I can't remember a playoff game where I saw Kobe Bryant score 0 points in a quarter.
JB, then Channing Frye snapped out of a huge funk.
Well, if you miss 17 in a row, you've got to believe that that 18th one has a great shot to go in.
Why?
And Channing, like JB, just kept shooting. Suns got hot in the second quarter, scoring 41, but Wilbon, while they got hot, he also did.
Yeah, Kobe Bryant, after, as Magic mentioned, not scoring in the first quarter, he wound up hitting 6 of 9 three-pointers. Those really are John Barry numbers, we call it. And he just took over the game for a while and got them back in the lead, actually late.
Kobe Bryant finished a game with 38 points and 10 rebounds, but it, 10 assists, excuse me, but it wasn't enough because the Suns bench dominated. Dog, Dragić, really?
Oh, this is nice.
Yes, very nice.
I don't think he knew what he was going to do, but it looked pretty at the end. Right hand, he's a lefty. Big time move, play of the game.
If you have S in horse and he did that shot, you're done. The Laker bench had 54 points, an 18-3 fourth quarter run from Phoenix. Suns even the series at 2 games apiece, headed back to L.A. for game 5 tomorrow night.
No, it was a lot of fun. It might have been the funnest game I've been a part of. You know, it was so great, you know, to see the second unit play so well. It was a lot of fun.
There's absolutely no doubt that we love this. You know, this is what champions are made of. You know, we had this situation in the Oklahoma. We had it with Denver last year in the finals. It should be like this. This is what it should be if you have the best teams in the West going up against each other.
Taking you next level to show you how the Suns' zone has thrown the Lakers off balance. Last night against Phoenix, suddenly vaunted zone defense. L.A. scored 33 points on 53% shooting in the first half, but in the second half, the Suns held Kobe Bryant and company to just 22 points on 33% shooting. For more on the Lakers' defense, let's throw it to the coach, our man Avery Johnson, for Avery's Angle.
While the major topic of conversation in the Los Angeles Lakers-Phoenix Suns Western Conference Finals matchup has been the Suns' zone defense, the major issue for the Los Angeles Lakers is their inability to get stops on defense. And mainly, it starts in transition. When you're in transition, it's about basketball threat. Lamar Odom is late. He's trying to run back to his man instead of picking up Dudley at the three-point line. Also, the Phoenix Suns, one of the best pick-and-roll teams in the league. Here, Bynum overcommits instead of zoning it up back near the free throw line. Because he overcommits, it forces Lamar Odom again to be out of position. Three-point basket for the Phoenix Suns. The last part of the Lakers' defense, they're not doing a great job of punishing the Suns in the paint. On this drive, Lamar Odom should have taken a hard foul. The Suns have no fear of scoring against the Lakers in transition with their pick-and-roll defense and also with their penetration. The Lakers need to step it up on defense.
Thanks for dropping by, Coach. And where might Avery coach again? We'll hear that later on in the show. All right, after looking unbeatable at home and then looking confused on both ends of the floor in Phoenix, Magic, what concerns you most about the defending champs?
Well, I think Coach Avery Johnson is right. When you think about the Lakers, the last 2 games, they have put the Phoenix Suns on the line 74 times. That means they're not moving their feet, they're reaching, and then they're not communicating on defense. They looked a little confused on defense, and they have to get that together. If they don't get that together, this team right now, to me, is feeling good, the Phoenix Suns, about themselves. So the Lakers must establish their defense in the first quarter at the Staples Center tomorrow night, or they're going to be in trouble.
I'm going to go to the offensive end. And the L.A. Lakers have been completely taken out of their game. And here's some alarming numbers. Games 1 and 2, they shoot 58%. In games 3 and 4, they shoot 49%. In games 1 and 2, 54 paint points. In games 3 and 4, 43 paint points. Took 33 threes in the first 2 games and took 60 in the next 2 games.
Wow.
So that's not their game. This is not a good three-point shooting team. Phoenix has made them into a jump shooting team. They're not. We all talked about the size. This is where they have an advantage. Just because it's a zone doesn't mean you can't use your size. And Kobe Bryant said it after the game. They are so consumed with attacking the zone that they've forgotten about the defensive end, exactly what Magic's talking about.
You know, we're at that point where in the past people would have dismissed Phoenix, particularly having to play 2 of the final 3 games, if necessary, on the road. Why? Not good enough defensively, no bench, no half-court offense.
Phoenix.
Right. but this Phoenix team can do all three of those things. You look at that bench. And particularly, I mean, Jared Dudley. Who was talking about Jared Dudley when the season started?
He's a throw-in in a
Dragić. Track. Barbosa was done. He was sort of out of the rotation. He's back to being Barbosa. Amundsen, Channing Frye, who you mentioned, you know, finding a shooting touch for 1 game. And all of a sudden, they're able to do some things. They've got some confidence in themselves, Magic. I spent a lot of time with the Suns this season. Now, I don't remember seeing in the past, before, defense to them meant, how quickly can we get the ball out of the net? and score at the other end. We'll give you two, and we'll take three. Different Suns mentality.
You know why they're confident? Because they beat San Antonio in San Antonio. So they're going to feel like we can go into the Staples Center and beat L.A. Lakers at home because they've done it already on the road in the playoffs.
And how about Coach Alvin Gentry keeping that bench on the floor for 9 minutes in that fourth quarter? 9 minutes, that bench. They held their own. They kept the lead. Steve Nash and Amari Stoudemire can stay and watch.
That, too, big, big confidence builder. One thing you cannot do, though, is pin the two Laker losses on Kobe Bryant. The Black Mamba became just the third player in NBA history with back-to-back 35-point, 10-assist games in the last 20 playoffs. And in that same time span, only Kobe and Michael Jordan have put up a 38-10 game along with 6 three-pointers. The difference is Jordan won his game in the 1992 Finals against Drexler and the Trailblazers. Kobe lost his game last night. Still to come, from Kobe to Phil, what will the Zen Master do next season? The latest on a coaching carousel starting to spin faster these days.
Stoli, thanks. Didn't recognize you without your pajamas.
Well, I'm not usually the suit and tie type.
Suits, ties, shoes, pants. Hey, I've earned the right to be comfortable.
Don't forget I started with nothing but a $1,000 loan from Mom.
But now look at you. I guess. But deep down, I'm just a guy like everyone else, looking for love. Love. Really.
Would you have a drink with you? The most original people deserve the most original vodka.
Hi.
The $2 meal deal. Is that really three items for $2?
It sure is.
So I buy a beefy five-layer burrito and drink, and you throw in the chips for free?
No, you pay for the burrito and chips, and you get the drink for free.
Actually, the drink and the chips are $2, and the burrito is free.
Tell you what, just give me $2, and it's all free.
Three items, $2. Now that's a deal.
Let's do it.
Taco Bell's $2 meal deal. Four different meals to choose from, each with a Taco Bell original, Doritos chips, and a medium soda. It's three for two and only at Taco Bell.
Here comes the changeup.
There's that changeup of beauty.
Fastball up and in.
Fastball up and in for a ball.
Slider in the corner.
Okay, guys, can we just watch the game?
But he's tipping his pitches.
No, I know.
Because it's not like it's annoying or anything. It's just I hate it a lot. Okay. Thanks for coming over.
Backdoor curve.
Still doing it. It's still that thing we were talking about.
And we head to the last of the fifth on ESPN Sunday Night Baseball.
Stay right there. I'll guide you to the ultimate in home entertainment. Bright House Network's HD Destination. It's one convenient location for the more than 100 HD channels available from the home of Free HD. Found in the 1000s on your channel guide, all our HD channels are grouped in easy-to-search categories. So if you want to explore HD movie channels, they're all listed together. So are HD Sports, HD News, and more. HD at its best from the home of Free HD.
At Dunning Refrigeration, we truly take care of our customers. And while that may be a cliche these days, we take it very seriously. You have our promise to do things right the first time and stand behind everything we do with a 100% satisfaction guarantee. We've been serving satisfied customers for over 38 years. Lower your utility bills with a new Carrier system with payments starting as low as $99. Save even more with rebates and tax credits. Turn to the experts at Dunning Refrigeration, someone you can trust, someone who cares.
This is Kia NBA Shootaround.
Invincible in Game 4? Well, some people will say more like invisible. Despite his team's victory, Vince Carter played 31 minutes to forget Monday night. Orlando hoping to welcome back Carter in Game 5, although Vince played more like horse shack on Monday. Welcome back. Vince had been averaging 18 a game in the first three games. He only scored 3 points, shot 11%, didn't hit a three, and pulled down just two more rebounds than JB did Monday night. From Vinsanity to the insanity, the NBA coaching carousel, let's check in with Will Bond and NBA insider Chris Broussard.
Thanks, Stuart. Okay, Chris, let's jump right into the Phil Jackson news. He seemed to close the door on a return to the Chicago Bulls, but he mentioned having a vodka with new Nets billionaire owner Mikhail Prokhorov. So you want to decipher that for us?
Well, with as much money as Prokhorov has, I'm sure Phil would like to have a vodka
over a long basketball discussion with Prokhorov. I talked to people close to Phil Jackson today, and they told me, look, he dislikes talking about his future during the playoffs because, one, he really wants to return to the Lakers next season, and, two, he doesn't want to be a distraction to his team during this series with the Phoenix Suns. Now, I've been told that if things don't work out with the Lakers once the season is over and he's not going to be their coach next season, then he'll be open to all possibilities, listening to all pitches, including the New Jersey Nets, including the Cleveland Cavaliers if they come his way, and even including the Chicago Bulls.
So you think the door is still open on all these possibilities?
His first choice is definitely to go back to the Lakers. But, yeah, the door will be open if that doesn't work out.
But can the New Jersey Nets do enough to make themselves attractive to Phil and, let's face it, LeBron James?
It's hard to imagine, isn't it, those two guys in New Jersey. But, you know, it's a new day there with Prokhorov and the moving to Brooklyn in 2 years. And they realize, people in the organization think it's a long shot, too, but they're going to take their best shot. That right now they have $27 million of cap space. The New York Knicks are the only team with enough room to offer two maximum level contracts to free agents. The Nets hope to get there within the next several weeks. They want to make a few moves, and they're even open to the possibility of trading their third pick in the draft if it can clear enough cap space. They need about $4 or $5 million more in room to get to offer two maximum level contracts to free agents, and it would be LeBron James and Chris Bosh, just like the Knicks are going after.
Any chance one of those guys could be Dirk Nowitzki, who we've been told is going to opt out of his contract to at least become a free agent? Could he leave Dallas and wind up anyplace else, Chris?
Dirk will not leave Dallas. The particulars haven't been ironed out yet, but expect Dirk to sign a multi-year deal with the Mavericks that's backloaded to enable them to have the financial flexibility to add a player or two and become a better team.
This is much better than hot stove. Stuart, back to you.
Monday night really was a Superman-like effort from Dwight Howard. He became the first player to put up a 32-point, 16-rebound, 4-block performance in a road elimination game. Don't, careful of the quads and the hamstring there. What makes him so tough to defend? Grab some quarters for John Berry's virtual world.
Welcome inside the EA Sports virtual playbook, where we're going to look at Dwight Howard and what I think is the best part of his offensive game. Here he is battling with Kendrick Perkins. Kendrick Perkins does a terrific job on Dwight Howard. He's fighting, he's battling. Don't let him catch. That's the best defense. But now when this shot goes up, Dwight Howard becomes the most dangerous guy on the floor. His ability to offensive rebound, nobody does it better. Kendrick Perkins unable to box him out. Dwight Howard gets the flush. If he catches it down there, you've got to wrap this guy up. Hey, sometimes the best Orlando Magic offense is simply a missed shot because Superman Dwight Howard, more times than not, is going to clean up that mess.
Thank you, JB. Tonight's Valvoline predicting victory question. What did the Celtics need to do to win tonight? We ask you, the people, and you all say, keep Dwight Howard under 15 points. That's what 40% of you say. JB, do you agree with that answer?
I do, because I haven't been right all year long. So I'm going with the public.
He going with the peoples. I love the people. Coming up, Wilbon goes one-on-one with Grant Hill. What does this first long playoff run mean to the 16-year veteran?
And, you know, for me, my Hall of Fame is the fact that I'm still playing. You know, the fact that I've gone through all that and I'm back, I'm competing, and I'm reliable.
Predicting Victory is brought to you by Valvoline. We can't guarantee your team's success, but Valvoline will guarantee your engine up to 300,000 miles. Goal to 43776 to get live World Cup games on your phone.
Isn't it a little late to be selling lemonade?
There should be more to a party than just beer. And Cheryl over there doesn't even drink beer.
Thanks.
Who's Cheryl?
I have no idea.
Don't forget the mics. Lemonade for grown-ups.
Go, dude, go! Are you sure the parachute was packed right? Probably!
Sometimes probably doesn't cut it. That's why Valvoline guarantees your engine up to 300,000 miles. Sign up at Valvoline.com.
Real
chipotle and red peppers, onions and Mediterranean oregano, a touch of amber honey, all in our authentic spicy chipotle sauce that's worthy of our all breast meat chicken. Wait till you taste how it comes together. Introducing Wendy's Spicy Chipotle Boneless Wings. Real is in the ingredients. And try the sweet and spicy Asian or honey barbecue.
You know when it's real.
Put a little twist in your day with your favorite sweets. Hand blended in a twisted frosty.
And you've got a pass on target. Here, Dwight Howard sprints the floor rim to rim, which holds Kevin Garnett in to protect against the direct pass, which opens up Rashard Lewis on the wing. Perfect pass by Jameer Nelson right into the pocket. And then, pick and roll game. Jameer Nelson aggressive, turning the corner to get into the paint, to collapse the defense. And again, passing on target. What comes first, great shooting or great passing? I say it's great passing. And then great screening. Instead of one screen, setting a staggered screen, two screens, which makes it harder to negotiate. Rondo gets hung up. Nelson hits the three. You see the great three-point shooting. My thing, though, is even more importantly, here on the road, is limiting their turnovers. Too many turnovers will hurt them here tonight.
But the three-point shooting certainly didn't last a couple of games. Meanwhile, for Boston, Park, we know it's all about balance with this team, but certain guys need to come up strong. Kevin Garnett is important for them now to advance.
Well, you talk about star players having to respond and act like star players when it matters most. Kevin Garnett has been struggling in this series. You talk about what he's done in the previous series. Outstanding job shooting, high percentage, doing it on both sides, scoring and also rebounding. Struggling against the Orlando Magic, not able to make shots. You talk about shots that we've become accustomed to seeing Kevin Garnett knock down, the running hook shot. Well, turnaround jump shot. He does this in his sleep. Has made a career of knocking these type shots down. Mid-range jump shot, 15 to 17 feet. Not able to knock them down. Wide open looks. At some point, Kevin Garnett has got to step up and make life easier for everybody else and knock these shots down.
After game five, Kevin Garnett said, it was a tough day for the Celtics. He'll try and make it a tough night for the Magic later on tonight, Stuart.
Tough life for Boston fans sometimes. Here we go, Boston fans, listen up. Second round of the hockey playoffs this year, the Bruins went up 3-0 on the Flyers, crushing Philly in game three by 3 goals. Series over, right? Right?
Yeah. Okay. Done.
Check the parallel. Game three in this series, Rajon Rondo, the play of the series so far. Boston blew the doors off Orlando by 23. They go up 3-0. Series over, right?
Over.
Let's go back to hockey. Game four, a nail biter, goes to overtime. Bruins lose game four. The Flyers now down 3-1. Game four in the East Finals, a nail biter that goes to overtime. You see the pattern, right?
No big deal. They're still up 3-1, Stewart.
But there's a pattern. Magic win it by four, now trail 3-1. So game five in hockey. Flyers crush the Bruins in Boston 4-0 to trail the series 3-2. And remember, it was 3-0. So game five in the East Finals, Magic crushed the Celtics. This one's in Orlando. Win by 21 and now trail their series 3-2. So you still say it's
so
no
what?
Big deal?
Up 3-2.
Yeah, well, back in hockey, game seven of Hockey Town in Boston, Flyers rally down 3-0, win 4-3, win the series. Edgy times in Boston, guys.
I'm really worried they might be the first team in history to lose four in a row.
I think it's the Bruins all over again, personally.
There's a reason why that Orlando was favored in this series to start with. I prepared myself, actually, for a loss. Orlando was going to win the series.
I can't believe this panic out there.
I'm really upset right now because I think the Celtics are in trouble. I think we're in trouble.
That's from WEEI Radio in Boston. The nerves frayed again in Beantown with more in playoff pressure. Let's send it to two guys who've been there, done that, and done that together with the Showtime Lakers, Magic Johnson and Byron Scott.
Well, Stuart, both Byron and I have been in some must-win situations.
Oh, yeah.
Take us back to 1985. You know, we were up on the Celtics 3-2. We were going back to Boston in a must-win situation for us because we didn't want it be to go to a game seven.
Right, right.
So what was your mindset?
You know what? The format was different. It was 2-2, 1-1-1 at that particular time. So when we were going back to Boston, I remember this vividly. I was talking to my dad, and I said, look, we don't want to come back home. We want to win this thing in the Boston Garden, something the Lakers team hadn't done in a long time, and we wanted to get that monkey off our back. So my whole attitude was to take the lead from my guys, my main man, Buck Rhone here, and was to just go out there on the court and play like it was our game seven, that we didn't have a chance to come back to Los Angeles.
I know, B, I had the same mindset, because when you get to Boston on the road and you're saying, man, what do I have to do as an individual? I knew I had to keep the pace up for us, because it was about running the basketball, making sure we kept pressure on them defensively as we ran our offense. And so it came out true for us that since I pushed the ball, everybody got involved.
Right.
They would try to stifle our fast break, but they couldn't do it. And then take us to 88. We had to win 3 7-game series.
Yes.
To win the championship. Now take us through the mindset of Detroit. We were tied 3-3, game seven.
Right.
What was your mindset then?
Well, you know what? I think we came into that game, into that series, we were going back home from Detroit down 3-2. We had the last two games at the Fabulous Forum. So, you know, the mindset was definitely to get to game seven and win game six, and we were able to do that. And in game seven, my mindset was just to attack. You know, try to keep attacking these guys, keep up the pace, like you said, because I knew Buck was going to push it. So myself and James Worthy had to continue to fill those lanes, because somewhere down the line in that game, we knew that team would break. And we always said, look, we're going to run for 48 minutes until that team has that little break in the armor, and we're going to take full advantage of it. And in that game, we got up to about a 14-15-point lead, and I thought, hey, we got this thing sold up.
Well, Byron, I want to take the fans through the minds of the point guards, Rondo and Jameer Nelson, because they are going to be the key. Just like when I played point guard, I had to establish a guy. Who was going to be the guy that would help us win? Whether it's going to be me getting Byron 10 or 15 shots tonight because I knew he had the mismatch, or was it James Worthy? Should I get him 10 or 15 shots because he had the mismatch? And then I knew Kareem would get himself involved because he was so great. So I had to figure out who I needed to score 10 to 15 points to help James and Kareem with the scoring. Tonight, Rondo has to figure out not only get himself involved,
but
also, is it Kevin Garnett? And I think the key to this game is Kevin Garnett. So he has to get Kevin Garnett going early to me. So how about from a coach's standpoint? You coached in the league.
Right.
You've been to the finals twice. What are the two coaches thinking for this big game six?
Well, I think just what you just said. They think the keys to this series has been the point guard play. Rondo has outplayed Jameer in the first three games. Jameer Nelson, the last two games, I outplayed Rondo. And Jameer Nelson understands right now that he has to pick the pace up. He has to continue to try to, you know, get to the basket. But I think the one guy that he has to try to get this game and get involved in this game is Vince Carter. And on the other hand, Rondo, Kevin Garnett, you don't know what the injuries are tonight with Big Baby and Rasheed Wallace and how much they can give you. So Kevin Garnett is a big key part to what they got to do tonight. Rondo has to get that man going early and often for them to have a chance to win this game.
Well, Stu, from two former Lakers, we're going to throw it right back to you.
Me and Wilbon just talking about, man, I remember watching him. It was so fun. Wilbon talks to Steve Nash about one glaring omission coming up.
Whether or not I accomplish a championship with the remaining years of my career, I'll find a lot of reward in my career, but that doesn't mean I'm not dying to get one.
Muscles. Oh, what muscles can do. From the jaw dropping You have got to be kidding me. Muscles to the sexy, supercharged, super stretchy muscles. Muscles that kiss it goodbye and speak for themselves. Oh, what muscles can do.
Come on!
Sunday Night Baseball. American League contenders collide at Target Field as resurgent Vlad Guerrero leads the Rangers against American League MVP Joe Mauer and the Twins. Rangers Twins Sunday at 8 on ESPN2. Everybody watches on Sunday night.
Soccer's best will shine in South Africa. Who is your pick to win the cup? Go to ESPN.com/bracket to play now. The 2010 FIFA World Cup on ESPN.
If the Magic take Game 6 tonight, it's going to set up a potentially historic Game 7 in Orlando Sunday night on ESPN. Coverage would begin with us on Kia NBA Shootaround at 7:30 p.m. Eastern. And one of the us, my man Michael Wilbon.
Charles Barkley, Patrick Ewing, Dominique Wilkins, Stockton, and Malone. Right now, Steve Nash is trying not to be grouped in a category with these players, Hall of Famers, who never won a championship. While those others were unfortunate enough to play in Michael Jordan's era, Steve Nash reached his peak at the same time Kobe Bryant and Tim Duncan were dominating the West. But don't think his lack of a title is for lack of effort. I sat down with Steve Nash before the conference finals began as his eye was still coming around from the round 4 TKO of the Spurs.
Nash on the drive. Nash takes it in. Nash scores. Took it right to the rim.
The stat that comes up, MVPs that haven't gotten to the finals. What do you think when you see that?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, you know, maybe if I should take some blame because I've never made the finals and I'm an MVP, I'll take it. I've also, I think, played in the most playoff games without a finals appearance. You know, I don't know. I don't know if I should beat myself up over that or if I should be water off a duck's back. Whether or not I accomplish a championship with the remaining years of my career, I'll find a lot of reward in my career, but that doesn't mean I'm not dying to get one.
Nash hands it off to Stoudemire.
How important is chemistry? Because it seems like sometimes it's overrated, but not this time.
Well, I actually feel lucky. I've been a part of most of the teams I've played on have had good chemistry, but this is just phenomenal. We have guys who are willing to sacrifice and willing to put the team first.
Is there some ingredient that you think that champions have?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's two things. One is being a winner. Being mentally tough, being unselfish, being smart. I think the second one is to have great teammates. You can't win a championship if you don't have a lot of talent. So, you know, there's a lot of guys who have the championship gene, but maybe you've never won. You know, I think a lot of it comes down to how good your talent and roster is, your luck, your timing, your health. But on top of that, you gotta have a group of guys that are winners.
Every time your name is mentioned, your age is also mentioned, or your draft class is mentioned, that comes into play. Do you actively think at all about how long you want to do this?
Not really. You know, I realize that, you know, I have 2 years left after this season, so there's going to be a decision to make then, but I haven't really thought about what that's going to be like or where I'll be mentally at that stage, physically. So while I know it's kind of looming there, you know, I'm just enjoying this right now, and I know that I still got a great opportunity to play basketball at a really high level for another 2 years, and on the tail end of that second year, I'll start thinking about what I want to do and if I want to come back and play or if I want to do something else or whatever the options may be for me. So I couldn't even begin to tell you what I'm going to feel like in 2 years.
Great player, great guy, right, Wilbon?
Absolutely. One of the best.
There's only one team in the history of the galaxy that's ever won 17 NBA championships. That franchise right there, storming the court. This year they want their 18th, but they might want to take care of business tonight. Game 6 coming up from Boston as the Celtics take the floor. So we know the pressure is on them because nobody in the NBA has ever gone up 3-0 and lost a series. But Orlando's got pressure because if they lose tonight, they're gone. Magic, key player in tonight's game for you.
Stuart, let's remember, this is a must-win for Orlando. But in Game 4, that was a must-win too, JB. And Dwight Howard had 32 points, 16 rebounds in that must-win situation. He led the team. He was energized. He played tough and physical, and he must do that again tonight.
I'm going to go with KG. And not just the numbers that are paltry at best. He's averaging 10 points a game, shooting 37%. He's only getting the line 2 times per game. No aggression, but it's on the other end. He's the guy. He's the emotional leader. We need to see him with that emotion, be aggressive, be the guy that anchors that great Celtic defense, like the one we saw the first three games of the series, like the one we saw in 2008 when they were NBA champions. It's time to put up or shut up. We know Kevin Garnett's not going to shut up.
No, he's not going to do that. I know Doc Rivers has been retired for a while, but can he be my key player anyway? I think it's Coach Doc Rivers.
You always put a monkey wrench in everything.
He's got really to
does.
Manage.
He doesn't listen, does he?
No, but think about this now. He's got to manage a roster of injured guys, guys who look a little tired, guys who maybe are losing a little confidence, guys who, like Kevin Garnett, JB, are slumping. I mean, Doc Rivers, who was credited, and I think justifiably so, with really helping the Celtics get back to that 2008 championship form, I think Doc has to do that again in rallying his players that way, because I know they got leaders on that team, but Doc Rivers has been a leader as well.
Wilbon mentions the injuries. It's injuries, and it's also the Kendrick Perkins situation. To recap, in case you weren't with us at the beginning of the show, Kendrick Perkins, who picked up his seventh technical of the postseason in the last game, which should be a one-game suspension, the league rescinded it, so Kendrick will play tonight. Big baby Glenn Davis got a concussion less than 48 hours ago. He will play tonight. Rasheed Wallace tweaked his back. Still, he will play tonight. How does all this affect this game, Magic?
Well, I think that, first of all, let's look for a spark plug for the Boston Celtics, because J.J. Redick, Brandon Bass, those guys are the spark plug for the Orlando Magic coming in off the bench. I'm looking for Nate Robinson to come in this game. He has to play. He has to, JB. He has to come in and give the Celtic some quality minutes, okay? And then Michael Finley, you got him, you traded for him, or you picked him up, rather. He can come in. He's played in big games before. Let's look for those two guys to come in and be a spark plug for the Boston Celtics.
Yeah, and Kendrick Perkins, a lot of pressure on him now. He's got the technicals. He's got to be on the floor to guard Dwight Howard. Keep your emotions in check. Getting technical fouls is putting yourself above the team. It's a selfish thing to do. They need him out there. Mind your P's and Q's and stay on the floor.
Because if he gets one more tech, he's out for the next game.
He's gone. To speak to your point about Nate Robinson, Doc Rivers told Nate Robinson as recently as middle of the series, after they had won a couple of games, actually after they had won three, told Nate Robinson he is still thinking that Nate Robinson is going to win a game for the Boston Celtics in these playoffs.
They're running out of time.
Tonight's
well,
tonight.
You know what? If you saved them, if that's the ace in your up your sleeve, that's a good time to have it.
Here's the thing about all this pressure for the Boston Celtics. They're used to pressure situations. In their run to the finals back in 2008 when they won the championship, Boston did not have a series that ended in fewer than six games. And last season, both of the Celtics series went seven games. And now, another grueling series with more from Boston. Here is Doris Burke again.
Stuart, thank you. Kendrick, obviously the good news is that one technical rescinded. The bad news is now you have to manage trying to play the game, understanding that if you get one more, you'll be suspended. So how do you manage that situation and still play your game?
You know, it's hard. You know, it's the playoffs, so it's intense down there in the paint. You know, sometimes you get wrapped up with guys not even trying to. So, you know, it's hard, but, you know, you just try to stay out the way, but at the same time, you try to play physical. But, you know, you go to the refs and you tell them that we're going to play physical tonight, go get tangled up. It's nothing personal. So, you know, you just try to play your game, but you can't really worry about it.
Last few days, everyone's talked about what the Magic have done well. They've been successful in the pick and roll. Dwight has been terrific. What do the Celtics need to get back to in order to wrap this up?
Play harder. I think they playing harder than us right now. You know, they playing like it's the game seven. You know, it is win or go home for them, you know, in the past few games. So I just think they've been playing harder than us, you know, attacking us, getting whatever they want. And we got to cover the three-point shot tonight.
Kendrick, thank you. Stuart, looking to get back to the intensity that we saw early from the Celtics in this series. Back to you.
Thanks a lot, Doris. Coming up next, the best from Wired in this series, the sounds from the first five games, and you're going to hear the coaches getting really, really geeked up.
Has to be with our defense.
We got to keep playing together.
And play the game we talked about playing.
One bucket at a time.
Hey, let's start right now. Get a stop.
Isn't it a little late to be selling lemonade?
There should be more to a party than just beer. And Cheryl over there doesn't even drink beer.
Thanks.
Who's Cheryl?
I have no idea.
Don't forget the mics. Lemonade for grown-ups.
You can make this stuff, right?
Probably.
Sometimes probably doesn't cut it.
That's why Valvoline guarantees your engine up to 300,000 miles. Sign up at Valvoline.com.
The challenge makes you stronger.
Every day, every moment.
You want my belt? Come and get it.
So, you want to be a fighter? This is how.
Rated T for team.
Saturday, bragging rights are on the line as 43 teams look to leave their mark at the track NASCAR calls home. Coming off a dominating win at Dover, reigning series champ Kyle Busch closes in on points leader Brad Keselowski, while Kevin Harvick goes gunning for his third win of the season at NASCAR's mile and a half Beast of the Southeast. The Nationwide Series at Charlotte. Coverage begins Saturday at 2 Eastern on ABC.
See the Rays take on the White Sox Saturday, May 29th at 7:10 p.m. Then rock with seven-time platinum recording artist Daryl Hall and John Oates. It's the Rays Summer Concert Series presented by Hess Express. They'll perform hits like Maneater, Private Eyes, and I Can't Go For That as part of Rays Saturday Nights presented by Bright House Sports Network. Tickets start at $18. Call 888-FAN-RAYS or visit RaysBaseball.com.
Conventional automotive frames absorb energy, but this one does more. It collapses in some areas while staying rigid in others to help redirect energy around the cabin and away from you. The Ace body structure in the Acura MDX. The most innovative thinking you'll find in an Acura.
Take advantage of attractive offers on the 2010 Acura MDX for well-qualified customers.
Welcome back to Kia NBA Shootaround.
A win tonight, you think Dwight Howard and the Magic will be pretty wired for a Game 7. Now after the last two wins, things sounding a bit better for Orlando, as you'll hear in this next segment, the best from our wire from the Eastern Conference Finals.
We got to keep our heads and stay focused on playing the game.
One of the two teams in this series eventually is going to take the easy way out. It's too hard. The ones that stay in there win.
Ray Allen left open. Quick release. Puts in the three. And it's a 16-point lead.
Settle down and play the game. We talked about playing.
Carter misses the second. Nelson puts it in.
It ain't going to be easy. But listen, we got to keep playing together.
Lewis shoots. That's a three. Won't go. Garnett the rebound. And that will do it. The Celtics take game one on the road.
Let's go get it. Let's be free. Showtime.
Hoorah.
Don't start forcing and rushing because of the pressure. Execute better.
Rondo, a pretty move from Rajon Rondo.
We can get back, but we're not going to be able to get back off all these turnovers.
Listen, play together. Keep moving the ball together, all right? We don't have to play any hero stuff.
Rondo fakes, scoops, and he puts it in. What a play from Rajon Rondo.
We're going to try to close this out two games. Y'all hear me? We're coming home to close it out.
We got to go get it. We got to be committed to it. We got to trust it. And we got to play hard for 48 minutes.
Right. We got to start it by dominating down there.
Allen to the basket. Oh, and a finish from Ray Allen.
We're not going to tie this in 3 minutes. Possession by possession, okay?
Rondo takes it away, spins, puts it off, banks it in. Rajon Rondo putting on a show.
We're going to win this game with our effort, our defense, and our rebound. All right, let's go.
Rondo goes at Barnes, blocked by Howard.
Hey, good start. Keep the energy up. Has to be with our defense.
They are the Eastern Conference champions, all right? Until somebody beats them. Until somebody beats them.
Pierce looking nearly stripped, knocked down. Picks it up, ball lost.
Move that ball. Trust each other.
Nelson again. Back-to-back threes for Jameer Nelson. And the Orlando Magic avoid the sweep and keep their season alive.
I kept looking for words, and the word was together. Together, 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 together. That's who we got to be. That's how we are great.
Oh,
Redick for three.
The two biggest things are taking care of the ball and getting backs right now.
One bucket at a time.
Closer, guys.
They're getting all the extra points on us. Come on.
Orlando wins game five. The Magic dreams of a championship still very much alive.
Paul Pierce's numbers down in the second half in the last two games. Will the truth set the Celtics free tonight? Preach there, Real. Game six just minutes away, so we are going on the floor next.
Come on, you can take a joke. You're the idol of millions of male libidos, I guess. But deep down, I'm just a guy like everyone else, looking for love.
Would you have a drink with you? The most original people deserve the most original vodka.
Donut head.
We've all heard the stories.
That you're special.
Magic even.
Hicks doesn't know how to die.
Given your abilities at killing men.
Your country needs you.
Why don't you just say that to begin with?
This war begins right here!
Ah! You get lost or get dead.
Jonah Hex.
What happened to your face?
Cut myself shaving. What happened to yours?
Starts June 18th. We were born to see the world in three dimensions. And the new Panasonic Viera Full HD 3D TV is the ultimate 3D experience. Immerse yourself in incredible depth and clarity thanks to fast-switching phosphors and Infinite Black Panel Pro.
Panasonic Plasma is the difference.
With 3D this lifelike, can we still call it a TV?
Goal to 43776 to get live World Cup games on your phone.
Kia NBA Shootaround, brought to you by the all-new 2011 Kia Sorento, official vehicle of the NBA.
Let's go on the floor in Boston. After tearing him down the first three games of this series, Wilbon, is it time to build Dwight Howard back up?
Well, it is. I mean, nobody can accuse Dwight of fooling around and not being nasty enough in the last two games. We're looking at Rajon Rondo now, who has looked injured to me in the last couple of games. We haven't seen the Rondo we saw earlier in the series getting to the basket and finishing. So they say he's not injured. He says he's healthy and ready to go. Are we going to see the Rajon Rondo of the first three games tonight in game six?
I do know the difference. That's Dwight Howard, big tall guy. Rajon Rondo, short guy. JB, big Dwight. Is it time to build him back up?
Well, this guy's been great the last few games, and the Orlando Magic have done a great job. In specific, Jameer Nelson has been a playmaker. Get this guy on the move, lobs, offensive rebounds, and he is a dominant center when he plays like that.
Vince Carter averaging less than 6 points in Orlando's two wins. Magic, does this mean the Magic don't need him to have a big game?
Oh, they definitely need him. And Vince Carter, this is what you dream of as a little kid, to be on the road, be down 3-2, to take it back home. We need a big game from Vince Carter.
All right. Tonight's Valvoline predicting victory. Guys, predictions. Who wins game six?
Boston will win. Too much experience, championship experience, been there before. And I'm picking the Celtics to close it out.
I'm going to go with the Boston Celtics. I believe they think this is a game seven. They have to win this game. They're not going to Orlando to win a game seven down in their place. Three in a row for Orlando will be too much for Boston to overcome. They get it done tonight.
May is a time for cliffhangers in primetime television, right?
Right.
So I see the Celtics getting on to about a 15-point lead, building it. I see Orlando bringing it back. I see overtime and...
Oh!
Celtics.
Okay. The last time that all three guys picked the Celtics, game four,
don't remind me.
Wrong. Thanks for watching us in Kia NBA Shootaround. Game six coming up. We'll see you at halftime.
Young Warrior. Your destiny is now. Watch the NBA Eastern Conference Finals on ESPN.
ESPN's presentation of the NBA Eastern Conference Finals. Brought to you by the new Miller Lite Vortex bottle. Taste greatness. And Nikon. Check out the ultra-compact and easy-to-use Nikon D3000.
That's
register for this. Oh, and that has hearts on it.
It's different than the other thing.
We're finally getting married.
I know.
Pick out something that's more your taste. I'll be right back. Duvets.
Oh, my taste.
Do you love the taste of your beer this much? Well, you could. Grab a Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite with that great Pilsner taste. Taste greatness.